It's derived from the Greek word myopia, which means to close the eyes. It's a refractive anomaly of the eye in which the focus is in front of the eye, is not accommodating, or in front of our retina. Cornea is steep and the crystalline lens problem. Degenerative myopia is one of the type as well. Inheritance, interruption of light passing through the ocular media, and then retinopathy. In this myopia, which is due to blood sugar level, exposure to sulfonamide and other pharmaceutical agents. The common signs and symptoms would be blurring of vision, okay, a simple degenerative has a distant blur is constant, nocturnal distance blur in dim illuminations or in dark conditions. To myopia naman, the blurred distance vision may be constant or intermittent with greater distance blur occurring after near work. Same dose, lasting from transient, okay, from few minutes to few hours to constant depending upon the particular agent or the condition causing it. So bakit natin nakikita nag-i-squint yung mga pasyente? Kasi light is concentrated. Headache, dahil nga sa eye strain, astenopia. And then they also blink excessively. Ito yung mga common na complications. Okay. And then available treatments. Okay. Optical correction, which is we use is minus spherical lens. Vision therapy, refractive surgery, and then patient education at the same time, yung mga family na rin. The next refractive condition will be hyperopia. Mas kilala natin sa term na farsightedness, or it will also be sometimes called as hypermetropia. So, ano nangyari dito is common refractive error in children, okay, and then short ng kanyang eyeball, or focus is exact or behind the retina. May classification system tayo ng hyperopia. The first one would be
created using Powtoon.